Ice in my veins, I've been driving this train. Years in this lane, there's no stopping this flame. Cause I came to the game and I changed it to play. How I like, rearranged it to my own domain. Yeah, I got what it takes, made lots of mistakes. Taking shots, skipping breaks, feeling lost, feeling great. Popping off, singing straight, never stopped, never changed. All the squad here to play and I've got something to say, yeah. I work hard each and every day. I get lost in the words I say. I don't push pause, no, I push play. I won't stop till I make a change. I withdraw on the things I make. I turn flaws into flawless traits.
What's going on, everybody? Thank you for tuning in here live on Beaufort Tone. Sorry about that stream restart there. Had a little computer issue, but I think we'll be all right from now on. Missed the coin toss there, but Beaufort High won the toss. They deferred to the second half. North Charleston will receive the ball here to start off tonight. I want to thank everybody for tuning in as well. We got another region contest here between Beaufort and North Charleston, and I believe that was North Charleston. I thought they were going to walk to the end, but they just ran down the sideline there on the same side, and here comes the Beaufort Eagles. Night here at the Nest. So all the seniors were announced for Beaufort, and I never really actually counted and paid attention to how many seniors there were on the team for Beaufort High, but I counted during that senior timeout. The players lined up from the 30 to the 30 on both sides of the field. And Beaufort is 22 seniors here on this team, so it's going to be a lot of retooling and reloading next year. The best part, the quarterback stays on both sides, actually, because Will Cotton in that middle, he stays. Tamari Bonds in the offense, true quarterback, he stays as well. So those two positions are going to be locked down. And you got your guy, Chaz and Jaden as well, the young guys up front on the defense. A lot of core players on this team that's playing this year is still going to be there next year. Of course, Amari Patterson, can't forget Amari Patterson, how well he's been playing this year whenever that ball's been able to be thrown inside his range. Forward to do the kick, and that ball is going to be fielded and brought around to the far left side. He's running the 450 yards to go wide on the side of the field, but didn't get too much far, but brings it all the way up to about the 35-yard line, and it looks like we got a player down on the far side of the field for Beaufort High. While he's down, we'll take a quick injury timeout break and we'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. Quick injury timeout to start. That was Sam Blackman down on the field for the Eagles. Had to be assisted off, but hopefully he'll be okay. This is being checked out on the bench. First down and 10 for the North Charleston Cougars. Drop back pass completed on that far outside. Xavion Capers, and he gets the first down to start off.
Pass complete on the play. Tackled on the play by number 87, Jerome Porter. Also in on the tackle at number 11, Brendan Ford.
A little bit of freeze frame on our replay there. We're trying to get that situated for you. First down and 10, Tyrell Gadsden, saw him last year. Back complete again, 3-2 on the connection. Looks like that might be the story of the night. As he goes to Capers with his second catch of the night and his many plays for the Cougars.
Number 56.
And Mr. Noah Alvarez in the chat, Beaufort High is still well in the line in the playoffs, even with the three losses. The only losses that count when it comes to playoffs is in your classification, which is the final five games. So they only have one loss to Phillip Simmons. So even if Beaufort High loses the night, top four teams still make the playoffs. The difference is if they fall into that third and fourth spot, they would have to travel on the road. They won't fall all the way to a five, which is Battery Creek, who is still winless on the season, and I don't see them pulling up an upset on anybody to close out. Nice play there by Beaufort, plus the third down. Gadsden drops back, trying to find some room. Launches one over the middle, trying to hit his man Antoine Spiller's ball, and complete. That's going to bring up fourth down and 12. Well, welcome to the chat, everybody. Marie Owens and Randall Corbett. We got a special... That's little Mr. Randall Corbett. Happy birthday to Mr. Randall Corbett, tuning into a lot of our live streams here this season. So shout out to Mr. Randall Corbett. And last year as well, he's kind of almost our playoff rules expert there, Mr. Corbett. Mr. Corbett keeping up with the high school sports here. And that is Riddy on the punt. That's right, Riddy normally wears the 7.
Ball
and tackled as there was no fair catch, brought down. And they're going to spot that ball at the Eagles' own 27. Looks like it's where they're going to spot that ball. That's what it'll be. But that is Sam Riddy Jr. He's rocking that 84 for the North Charleston. That normally wearing 7, I guess, an issue with the jerseys, but. Flags everywhere, false start.
Replay, first down.
And the Eagles going the opposite way they would like to go. Bonds to QB, he's going to hand it off, going around that left hand side, and he's got room, and he's got the first down. Eli Johnson on the carry for the Eagles.
Coming to number 24, Elias Johnson. Looking at the far field. Looks like we're going to be called second and inches in on the play.
Excuse me, second down and inches is going to be the call. Mark it just a little bit short. And never mind, they're going to call it a first down and moving the chains. And so it's first down and 10. Bonds drops back in the pocket, trying to find some room. That one's thrown deep. It's caught. Oh, complete. The pass on the catch. And that's going to be a big first down. Once again, our replay struggling a little bit here tonight. Bonds drops back, quick pass underneath, complete to Odom. Odom sliding his way through a defense, big hit at the end, but still a first down, and we've got goal to go now for the Eagles.
First and goal comes in the ball hit.
Looks like we're going to get a timeout for Beaufort.
We got a timeout coming on the field.
And we'll be right back. First and goal for the Eagles, and whistles blown, flags come in.
We got a false
and that's going to be a false start on the Eagles.
Back up 5 yards, it'll remain first down and goal to go.
The man in motion, more flags coming in, and another false start on the Eagles is going to be the call.
We got a false start going against the Eagles. We're back in the
5 yard. Bonds stepping back, going to hand it to Johnson around the left side. Johnson trying to find some room. It looks like he's going to get it down to about that 7 yard line. Bonds, this time handoff to Andrews around the right-hand side. His first carry of the night, trying to spin through those defenders, and he's finally brought down.
We're going to have a third and goal.
Third and goal now for the Eagles. Look like they were on their way to punching that in very quickly here. But third down and goal, manageable ball on the 4 yard line. And they're going to go heavy. Ronald Johnson and Will Cotting in. Direct snap coming to Andrews, and he fumbles the snap, quickly dives on it, and that's going to be fourth down.
And
that's going to be fourth and goal for the Eagles. Let's see if they'll like to go for it or go for the field goal. And it looks like the offense is going to stay on the field here. This time he catches it cleanly, and he's going to run into the end zone. Touchdown, Jaden Andrews. Kick is off for Brendan Ford, fielded at about the 5-yard line. Once again, taking the long way to get a gain of about 10 yards there, trying to stay up and a little extra that's at the end there. Nice play, first down and 10 for North Charleston. First down to 10 for the Cougars. And that's going to be a short gain on the play. Going to gain about 2 yards on the carry. Bring up second down and 8. Pass to the outside, shaking off a tackle, trying to make some room. Xavion Capers, nice work here. And he's got 2 catches for first down for the Cougars. Pass to Capers on that outside.
Green there, push the ball out of bounds. Second down, Eagle defense.
Make a second down and one for the Cougars. We got Miss Renee Brown in the chat cheering on Jamin Odom. Welcome to the chat, Miss Brown. The deep back behind Gadsden looks like they're going for the reverse. And sitting right on it, nowhere to go, Caleb Omer. Gadsden trying to find Tyrone. That's a fumble on the play. It's picked up by Omer. He's into the end zone. Touchdown, Caleb Omer. It's a tackle for a loss. This time a scoop and score. Caleb Omer. It looks like the ref started to calm down on the celebration a little bit there. Keisling on to kick the extra point. And a flag on the play.
Whistle blowing the play dead.
And it looks like it's going to be offsides on the Cougars. Going to move them up half the distance to the goal. Make it just a little bit easier there. And the kick is up. And it's good. Coming down the right-hand side on the return. Nice return there for North Charleston, but we got flags on the play.
Got a personal foul
against North Charleston.
penalties are the call. We're going to have a first down for the Cougars. Intended for the wide receiver, almost picked on the play. We're gonna have a second down. Ball batted down on the play for number 40, Robert Johnson. Ball carrier brought down.
Third down and 12, Gadsden rolling out to his left. Ball caught, trying to get the first down, and it looks like he does. It slides out of bounds. First down and 10 for North Charleston.
Looks like the ball came to be short of the first down, and a fourth and short to go for the Eagle Bees.
And they're going to call it short, fourth down and one. Gadsden going under center for one of the first times tonight, and he's got the first down. And right on the line. And it looks like the referee wants to signal first down and does. First down and 10. For North Charleston, making headway their first time inside of Eagle territory tonight.
The ball carrier with enough yards on the play, it'll be a first down for the Cougars.
Yeah, folks. Now I was working on that instant replay. That's a little bit of the radio silence there. A little bit on my end. You know, the scoreboard wasn't updated. That was my fault. I was trying to focus on trying to fix those replays there. I couldn't get it right for you on the fly. So I apologize about that. But,
timeout called on the field by the Cougars with
and 2 points. And we got a timeout, North Charleston. We'll be right back. Fresh set of downs for North Charleston after the timeout. Gadsden rolling out to his right side, trying to find some room. Throws it. He's got a man. Ball complete. That's going to be Rashad Clement on the catch. Nice catch and throw. North Charleston starting to put together a nice drive here. Started off by the nice return. And see if North Charleston can put it all the way together here. They are inside the red zone now. Ball on the 19-yard line for the Cougars. Gadsden empty backfield, Cotting in his face, trying to get it to John Brown. This plays the middle linebacker for them, but ball is going to be incomplete. Will Cotton was barreling down on Gadsden. Second down and 10 now for the Cougars. Gonna take a timeout. He was trying to get his guys in order, and then just a little bit of miscommunication and forced them to go over to the sideline and talk some things out. Timeout by the TV. We'll take a quick commercial break and we'll be right back. First and 10, Gadsden and the crew. Hopefully they got everything squared away this time. Looks like Brett was the man supposed to come in motion. They faked the reverse, try to go with the design QB run. But Will Cotting and Simmons right there. Nowhere to go for Gadsden on the play. Play and a delay a game on North Charleston. Drops back, Gadsden rolling out to his left. Guess who? Simmons and Cotton again. He chucks one back towards the end zone and it actually flies out of bounds. No, where to go? Gadsden looking for some room. He tosses one up towards the corner of the end zone and almost intercepted. Edward Green had his hands on it. Oh, incomplete. It's going to go down as a pass breakup. And that's going to be a turnover on down. And here comes Samari Bonds in the Eagles' offense. since Andrews and motion to Barnes looks to keep himself running around the left-hand side, bottom of your screen, and he's going to get the first down. Jamar Dodds taking a big hole. Just sliding, using that slender frame to just kind of slide through there. And Samari Bonds. Bonds looking to throw. He chucks one out to the far side and just too far for Patterson. Ball incomplete.
Coming from Samari Intent for number 15, Amari Patterson. Incomplete on the play. Set up a second down. Off.
Johnson around the bottom of your screen.
And
looks like he might got enough for the first down. And that's going to be the case. Moving the chains. Johnson on the carry in the middle. Second down and six. Low snap, handoff is to Johnson again, finding some room around that left side, sliding through there, brought down, and a little bit of clapping there on the outside. But Kamarion Smith, first down play, I don't think that was time down 14-0 for that one, but players are going to play, so they're going to talk a little bit at all times. Bonds trying to find some room, rolling out to his left hand side, chucks one up, and ball's going to be incomplete. We're actually a little bit ahead on our scoreboard here, so we're going to reset it 15 seconds. Up is to Andrews up the middle, and that's going to do it for the end of the first quarter. Apologize here, a little bit rough here to start the game here, but that's going to be the end of the first quarter. Your score, Beaufort on top 14, North Charleston 0 when we return.
Ridgeland, Hampton, Walterboro, Hardyville. If you've been injured in an accident, Door Law Offices are available 24 hours a day.
An accident can change your life in a moment. You miss work. You can't enjoy activities with your family. Medical bills are piling up. Don't trust your future to an out-of-town or out-of-state law firm. Door Law Office is a part of our community. Our attorneys are local, fighting for our neighbors in the Lowcountry. Door Law Office. Experience, tradition, integrity, excellence.
Beaufort, Ridgeland, Hampton, Walterboro, Hardeeville. If you've been injured in an accident, Door Law offices are available 24 hours a day.
An accident can change your life in a moment. You miss work. You can't enjoy activities with your family. Medical bills are piling.
Welcome back, everybody, into the second quarter. Jaden Andrews on the carry. Quickly wrapped up. And again, it's going to bring up fourth down for the Eagles. Get a timeout. Eagles, they're going to discuss some things. Their second fourth down of the night here.
We got a moment. We do got a birthday in the house here in the Eagle Nest. Miss Madison Gentry, happy birthday.
Bonds, quick throw to Cotton. Cotton on the catch. The linebacker refusing to go down, getting them a little bit of time, trying to get the first down. And it's going to be enough. Cotton, I believe that might be his first catch on the year. Might be his actual first catch in the game. I'm not sure. Cotton, he gets the reception. You see his teammates, that smart Bonds and Andrews coming up to him, saying good job, make the first catch up in the game there. Bonds backing up his running backs, hands it to Andrews around the right-hand side, and tiptoeing, trying to stay in bounds, but running out of real estate. Hand off this time to Johnson. Johnson following Andrews on the lead block. He took a couple of rough hits on his way in the middle of the hole, but able to stay up. And another first down for the Eagles. Move the ball here against Wolf Johnson. Priester in motion, a quick pass outside to Patterson. And quickly hopping on him, Kamarion Smith out there.
Coming to the near side of the field, short gain on the play, second down.
Bonds gonna keep it himself in a wide open hole. Touchdown, Samari Bonds.
Yeah.
Kick is up from Kaiserling. And it's good. Tackle once more for the Eagles. That's going to be 21-0 here up in the second quarter. Just under 10 minutes left to go. Don't forget, if you're tuning into this game and you're a student in the Beaufort County area, you're more than welcome to join our crew if you're interested in sports broadcasting. It's open to all Beaufort County School District high school students. We meet Wednesdays at the Beaufort Digital Corridor downtown on Carteret Street, 3 and 4 p.m. Back classes, whichever one you be able to make. And look for reporters and camera operators. Great opportunity for some hands-on learning in the field. Just shooting me a message here on any of our social media pages or at info@beaufortzone.com. Ball picked up at the 30-yard line. Kamarion Smith refusing to go down. Another broken tackle. Kamarion Smith with the big return from the 30 to the 30. A nice 40-yard return for Kamarion Smith. And they're going to spot that ball at the 31-yard line inside of Eagles territory here. A nice return from Kamarion Smith of North Charleston. Gadsden rolling out to his left and trying to find the man nowhere to go. Close first to the ball in the green and white jersey. Gadsden almost tried to get it off, and he's going to be sacked. Simmons and Keon Rivers. Gadsden, empty backfield, keeps it himself, showing up the speed, rolling to the right side. He's got the first, rolling out, excuse me, not out of bounds. He got the sack. It looked like he got enough for the first, but it's still going to be fourth and six. Looks like where they're going to mark it. Gadsden has Rhett to his side now. Looks like he's going to try to keep it himself. Omer on the outside, catching a piece of that fancy feet from him. And he just touched Gadsden on the way out, and a flag was thrown. And I really hope that's not a late hit call on Dom Camacho here. That's a real tic-tac penalty there. And it's going to be a personal foul on the defense. I'm pretty sure that was on Dom. He was the only person over there at the time. And that's a real ticky-tack call there, right there by the White House. And that's going to move the ball up. First down and 10 for North Charleston. Ball inside the 10-yard line. Going to be placed about the 8.5, really. First and goal, handoff is the red, breaks the tackle on the outside to Johnson, but here comes the rest of the Eagles. That's gonna back them all the way up. It's gonna be a 3-yard loss. Ball now gonna be on that 11-yard line, second and goal. Gadsden clears it out, trying to find some room. Looks like he's going to try to take off again. This time he throws it short. He's got Riddy inside the 5. Going to tackle him out at the 2-yard line. And the Cougars are knocking on the door. Yeah, third down and goal. Marker says first, but I'm pretty sure that was third down. Oh, I apologize. There was the penalty that moved them forward. Kind of threw me off there. So, all right, second down and goal. Apologize there. I got off track there. They didn't have the downs markers on the outside. I mean, the yard markers on the outside. They just had the down marker. So I thought it was and goal. And I think you guys saw the same thing too, unless maybe I was tripping there. And we're gonna get a timeout in North Charleston. As now they flip the downs marker. It's fourth down. Or the downs marker there. I know it's not me right now. So we take a quick commercial break and we'll be right back. Folks, welcome back here into the second quarter. It's fourth and goal, and I figured out the confusion exactly what happened. The downs marker on the outside, it's been goal to goal this whole time, but he actually just flipped it the wrong way on second down. So instead of flipping it to a 3, he flipped it backwards to a 1, and then they got it correct, and now it's fourth down for the Cougars. Gadsden looking for some room to throw, trying to scramble. He's going to run forward. Hit by Camacho, but he's going to get into the end zone. Touchdown for Gadsden and the Cougars. They get 6 by the feet of Gadsden. It looks like they're probably going to let to go for 2. Gadsden going to get the play. Cats drop back, throws one over to the left side, trying to hit Capers. He's been quiet a little bit. And that's going to remain 21-6. The cool night here in Beaufort, 61 degrees. Little bit of rain earlier, and I tell you what, we were looking at it, and it looked like it was supposed to go past, and it looked like there was a percentage, and it said it was going to rain only on Friday, all weekend. You know, when you get here, and it's been sunny all day, it's like, it's not going to rain. And then we get here, it rains for a little bit around like 2 o'clock and then disappears, so we think the rain has passed. Chances go down to like 15%. We're thinking we're good, and about an hour before kickoff, we get a pour down of rain. Up here, we had to hurry up and cover the cameras and everything and get set up. Myself and Coach Rass getting the guys set up over there for the film before the Eagles are popping up these canopies real quick to protect all of our equipment. But it's clear now, it's past. Beautiful weather here for some high school football, and a short kick there, quickly caught and falling on there by the Eagles. Shuler Baggett. And it's gonna be a penalty on the kicking team. I didn't see exactly what happened there, but I gotta back him up, make him real quick from the 35. And this time, Riddy Jr. kicks it a little bit deeper, fielded at about the 32 by Odom. An 18-yard return for the wide receiver. First down and 10 for the Eagles. Bond's going to keep it himself running up the middle. Going to run into Jakari Chisholm and Kamarian Smith, who seems to be everywhere tonight for North Charleston. Quick pass to the pass. Pass trying to break that tackle and thrown out of bounds there. First down and 10 for the Eagles. Comes Bonds, and he's got a lane, and he's going to the end zone. Samari Bonds. And there go the individual handshakes there to the quarterback and his teammates. Kick is up, and another one for the Eagles. And ladies and gentlemen, that is a big one right there. You hear the update come over the PA system. Hanahan is up 28-13. And Philip Simmons beat Beaufort High earlier this year. And so that's going to be one of those things again where the last week of the season, it could come down to the same way it did last year, down to a three-way tie. Beaufort has to go to Hanahan. If they can beat Hanahan, then it'll force that three-way tie, Hanahan having that one loss in the region right now. But that would shake some things up for Beaufort to be able to turn around and be able to possibly win this region. But we'll definitely continue to be able to keep an eye on that game, but you heard it, folks. Hanahan up 28-13 on Philip Simmons. Board the kick to the South Carolina logo, about the 35, making his way around that far side. Lorenzo Kitching Jr. going all the way, trying to get that far sideline. He ran 50 yards and probably gained about 15. And it looks like we got a player down on the field for the Eagles. So we're going to take a timeout, injury timeout, and we'll be back. Back first down and 10 for North Charleston. Scored on the last drive. Ball tipped up. It's caught. It's Denton. The homecoming king gets an interception. James Denton on senior night. And that's going to be a turnover for the Dolphins, for the Eagles. Some of the scores around the area. Hanahan 28-13 on Philip Simmons, and Bluffton up 14-3 at the half against May River as Bonds drops back looking for some room. He launches one deep and can't connect with Odom, and Odom pulls up, and it looks like he might have pulled something there. Hopefully he'll be okay as he comes limping off there trying to stretch out. Then he signals for someone to come on to the field for him. And well, Branch up 28-6 on Branchville. Looks like they'll stay on the way to staying undefeated here at the half. And Bonds, he's got a lane. He's trying to run, trying to get full speed. Gallivan breaking tackles and finally brought down. The long game by Kitchen Jr., but a first down by Samari Bonds. Bonds hands it up to Johnson. Johnson run around the left hand side. He's in green. He's got green. And finally chased out of bounds to the 8-yard line. Actually, they're going to give him some more And that spot at the three is where they're going to give them first down and goal for the Eagles. Handoff is to Johnson, and it's wide open. Touchdown, Mr. Eli Johnson, the third. Gets a touchdown on the night. Kiesling on the extra point attempt, and it's good right through the uprights. Make it 35 for the Eagles. I also want to use the time to give a shout out to our partners at the Beaufort Digital Quarter for allowing us to use their networking space downtown where we hold our pre-production meetings as well for the students. And if you'd like to join us, you can meet us there as well. And if you're a tech entrepreneur and you need a co-working space, you be able to showcase your ideas and talents, or just hit up Jesse McClue at the Beaufort Digital Quarter, and I'll be sure to welcome you on in. Ford kicks it one short again, and this time it's going to go out of bounds.
Nice effort coming right here. We got a flag.
And then coming to flag, and most likely that's going to be a kicking out of bounds. And Homer came in flying for that one, trying to stop going out of bounds. After all the penalty yards have been assessed, it's first down and 10. Gadsden with the empty backfield, quick throw over the middle. And ball incomplete. John Brown on the catch.
Ball carry is a little short. We got a second down and one to go over that Eagle D.
And Mr. Will McElhinney, and a shout out to the student section, trying to tell them to get loud. I tell you what about that student section. They arrived a little bit late here. They're starting to get some numbers here. Everybody realizing it's not going to rain all night, but the start of the game, it was almost virtually empty over there in the student section. You had more parents than students at the game, and so it's definitely not at the numbers that it usually is. We're looking out for that rain here for what's supposed to be a blackout night. for the Eagles. And Gats is going to break the pocket. He's going to do it himself. And he's going to try to run towards out of bounds, but he's not going to make it. Chase down.
Number 45, Reese Mullen bringing the ball carrier out.
Second down. Gats rolling to the bottom of your screen, and that ball is going to be complete on the outside. Rashad Clement.
15 seconds to go. If you are here to escort one of the seniors being recognized tonight at halftime, please.
First
make
down
your
and 10, moving the chains
to
for
the
North
Eagle
Charleston.
Entrance right by the concession stand. Once again, if you are here tonight to escort one of the cheerleaders, athletic trainers, or band members that are being recognized here at halftime, please make your way to the Eagle Walk entrance right by the concession stand.
Gats in hand off the red up the meadow. And the other number five, Will Cotton. Coming in and saying that he's the real number five. Gatson just launches one up, and it's going to be intercepted. Tyleek eyes him on the interception as Gatson just kind of threw it up there as he saw the pressure. Bonds and crew back on the field. Bonds gonna keep it himself and quickly brought down. Mikael Dukes getting into the backfield. Bonds drops back ball, quickly complete to Patterson. Patterson trying to break some tackles and held on to Jaden Sparks on the tackle.
Looks like we got to pick up about 7 on the play. Set up a 3rd and 5 for the Eagles.
Hand off to Andrews around the bottom of your screen. Dragon defenders. He breaks that tackle. He's still up. But the rest of the Cougars are going to get there, and he's still up on his feet. Jaden Andrews, vice running back for the Eagles. The tough yardage there, and he gets the first down. Bonds drops back the pass, throws one deep around the far side and try to go for the one-hander. We got flags on the play. The pass, the intended receiver. That's
going to
be pass interference on the defense. First down for the Eagles. You see the yards being marked off there. And that's going to put them inside of Cougar territory. Ball on the 43-yard line. Bond's going to keep it himself, and a pancake block by Lamb. And oh my God, another one by Lamb, two in a row with the lead block. And Samari Bonds gets a long 43-yard rushing touchdown. Big Adrian Lamb, oh my God, I wish the replay was working. I'd love to play that back. You don't get an opportunity to give the big guys, you know, an instant replay like that. And I tell you what, Odom. Oh, and there's a flag on the play. They called it back. Never mind. And that's going to be a holding call. They're going to dial it back, and that ruins that highlight there. I'm going to stop talking about it, but still, neither Adrian Lamb, the big guy, running down the field. That's what you want to see from your offensive lineman, especially knowing he's on the opposite side, pulling and getting through. Handoff is going to be to Andrews up the middle, breaking some tackles, refusing to go down. And it's another touchdown for the Eagles. This time, no flags on the play. Kai's looking for another extra point attempt. It is good. Tackle on another one. We got 42-6 here. And the first half, just under 2 minutes left to go.
Thank you.
Welcome back, everybody. A little bit under 2 minutes left to go here. Quick injury timeout there on the field. First down to 10, empty backfield for Gadsden. He motions to Rhett, hands off to Rhett. And once again, tackled by number five. Gadsden throws another one up. This time it sails towards the sideline, hits the track, and a flag on the play. He's going to keep it himself, and he's going to get the first down, run out of bounds safely to avoid the contact. Gadsden look for some room on the reverse course, trying to roll it to his left, and he's just going to throw that one out of bounds. Second down and 10 for North Charleston. Update: Bluffton 21-6 over May River. Beaufort Academy losing 21-3 to Colleton Prep. Royal Branch up 42-6 against Branchville. Down and 15. Gadsden design QB run, going to keep it itself. He's going to get away from Camacho, but not away from Robbie Winburn in this tackle. Another third down and 9 to go for North Charleston. Top rolling down here in the first half. Just under 20 seconds, and that might be the last play they're going to get off here. And they're going to take their time, and I think they might be trying to go towards the half. Nash going to snap the ball, hand off to Rhett. Nowhere to go. Jaden Simmons quickly in the backfield, and that's going to do it, folks. Half time. Beaufort up 42-6 on North Charleston. when we return, second half action.
Beaufort, Ridgeland, Hampton, Walterboro, Hardyville. If you've been injured in an accident, Door Law Offices are available 24 hours a day.
An accident can change your life in a moment. You miss work. You can't enjoy activities with your family. Medical bills are piling up. Don't trust your future to an out-of-town or out-of-state law firm. Door Law Office is a part of our community. Our attorneys are local, fighting for our neighbors in the Lowcountry. Door Law Office. Experience, tradition, integrity, excellence.
Beaufort is the kind of place you never want to leave. So what better place to build, live out dreams, and carve the future? A place for creators to converge and connect. The innovators, the moneymakers, the collaborators, those who imagine a new Beaufort and beyond. A place that intersects diversity, deep historical roots, and modern technological advancements. A place to scale your business and build your brand. We're the Beaufort Digital Corridor, your co-working space, business incubator, and technological hub. Welcome to your place to do more.
I hope you're enjoying the game as much as I am. My name is Javon Livingston, founder of Beaufort Zone. And we're looking for sponsors for our live streams. We're going to be broadcasting Beaufort High sports all year long. So you name it, football, volleyball, basketball, softball, baseball, all right here on Beaufort Zone. And we're looking for sponsors. So send us an email at info@beaufortzone.com.
Beaufort, Ridgeland, Hampton, Walterboro, Hardyville. If you've been injured in an accident, Door Law Offices are available 24 hours a day.
An accident can change your life in a moment. You miss work. You can't enjoy activities with your family. Medical bills are piling up. Don't trust your future to an out-of-town or out-of-state law firm. Door Law Office is a part of our community. Our attorneys are local, fighting for our neighbors in the Lowcountry. Door Law Office. Experience, tradition, integrity, excellence.
Beaufort is the kind of place you never want to leave. So what better place to build, live out dreams, and carve the future? A place for creators to converge and connect. The innovators, the moneymakers, the collaborators, those who imagine a new Beaufort and beyond. A place that intersects diversity, deep historical roots, and modern technological advancements. A place to scale your business and build your brand. We're the Beaufort Digital Corridor, your co-working space, business incubator, and technological hub. Welcome to your place to do more.
I hope you're enjoying the game as much as I am. My name is Javon Livingston, founder of Beaufort Zone. And we're looking for sponsors for our live streams. We're going to be broadcasting Beaufort High sports all year long. So you name it, football, volleyball, basketball, softball, baseball, all right here on Beaufort Zone. And we're looking for sponsors. So send us an email at info@beaufortzone.com.
Beaufort, Ridgeland, Hampton, Walterboro, Hardyville. If you've been injured in an accident, Door Law Offices are available 24 hours a day.
An accident can change your life in a moment. You miss work. You can't enjoy activities with your family. Medical bills are piling up. Don't trust your future to an out-of-town or out-of-state law firm. Door Law Office is a part of our community. Our attorneys are local, fighting for our neighbors in the Lowcountry. Door Law Office. Experience, tradition, integrity, excellence.
Beaufort is the kind of place you never want to leave. So what better place to build, live out dreams, and carve the future? A place for creators to converge and connect. The innovators, the moneymakers, the collaborators, those who imagine a new Beaufort and beyond. A place that intersects diversity, deep historical roots, and modern technological advancements. A place to scale your business and build your brand. We're the Beaufort Digital Corridor, your co-working space, business incubator, and technological hub. Welcome to your place to do more.
I hope you're enjoying the game as much as I am. My name is Javon Livingston, founder of Beaufort Zone. And we're looking for sponsors for our live streams. We're going to be broadcasting Beaufort High sports all year long. So you name it, football, volleyball, basketball, softball, baseball, all right here on Beaufort Zone. And we're looking for sponsors. So send us an email at info@beaufortzone.com.
Beaufort, Ridgeland, Hampton, Walterboro, Hardyville. If you've been injured in an accident, Door Law Offices are available 24 hours a day.
An accident can change your life in a moment. You miss work. You can't enjoy activities with your family. Medical bills are piling up. Don't trust your future to an out-of-town or out-of-state law firm. Door Law Office is a part of our community. Our attorneys are local, fighting for our neighbors in the Lowcountry. Door Law Office. Experience, tradition, integrity, excellence.
Beaufort is the kind of place you never want to leave. So what better place to build, live out dreams, and carve the future? A place for creators to converge and connect. The innovators, the moneymakers, the collaborators, those who imagine a new Beaufort and beyond. A place that intersects diversity, deep historical roots, and modern technological advancements. A place to scale your business and build your brand. We're the Beaufort Digital Corridor, your co-working space, business incubator, and technological hub. Welcome to your place to do more.
I hope you're enjoying the game as much as I am. My name is Javon Livingston, founder of Beaufort Zone. And we're looking for sponsors for our live streams. We're going to be broadcasting Beaufort High sports all year long. So you name it, football, volleyball, basketball, softball, baseball, all right here on Beaufort Zone. And we're looking for sponsors. So send us an email at info@beaufortzone.com.
Beaufort, Ridgeland, Hampton, Walterboro, Hardyville. If you've been injured in an accident, Door Law Offices are available 24 hours a day.
An accident can change your life in a moment. You miss work. You can't enjoy activities with your family. Medical bills are piling up. Don't trust your future to an out-of-town or out-of-state law firm. Door Law Office is a part of our community. Our attorneys are local, fighting for our neighbors in the Lowcountry. Door Law Office. Experience, tradition, integrity, excellence.
Beaufort is the kind of place you never want to leave. So what better place to build, live out dreams, and carve the future? A place for creators to converge and connect. The innovators, the moneymakers, the collaborators, those who imagine a new Beaufort and beyond. A place that intersects diversity, deep historical roots, and modern technological advancements. A place to scale your business and build your brand. We're the Beaufort Digital Corridor, your co-working space, business incubator, and technological hub. Welcome to your place to do more.
I hope you're enjoying the game as much as I am. My name is Javon Livingston, founder of Beaufort Zone, and we're looking for sponsors for our live streams. We're going to be broadcasting Beaufort High sports all year long. So you name it, football, volleyball, basketball, softball, baseball, all right here on Beaufort Zone. And we're looking for sponsors. So send us an email at info@beaufortzone.com.
Beaufort, Ridgeland, Hampton, Walterboro, Hardyville. If you've been injured in an accident, Door Law offices are available 24 hours a day.
An accident can change your life in a moment. You miss work. You can't enjoy activities with your family. Medical bills are piling up. Don't trust your future to an out-of-town or out-of-state law firm. Door Law Office is a part of our community. Our attorneys are local, fighting for our neighbors in the Lowcountry. Door Law Office. Experience, tradition, integrity, excellence.
Beaufort is the kind of place you never want to leave. So what better place to build, live out dreams, and carve the future? A place for creators to converge and connect. The innovators, the moneymakers, the collaborators, those who imagine a new Beaufort and beyond. A place that intersects diversity, deep historical roots, and modern technological advancements. A place to scale your business and build your brand. We're the Beaufort Digital Corridor, your co-working space, business incubator, and technological hub. Welcome to your place to do more.
I hope you're enjoying the game as much as I am. My name is Javon Livingston, founder of Beaufort Zone, and we're looking for sponsors for our live streams. We're going to be broadcasting Beaufort High sports all year long. So you name it, football, volleyball, basketball, softball, baseball, all right here on Beaufort Zone. And we're looking for sponsors. So send us an email at info@beaufortzone.com.
Beaufort, Ridgeland, Hampton, Walterboro, Hardyville. If you've been injured in an accident, Door Law offices are available 24 hours a day.
An accident can change your life in a moment. You miss work. You can't enjoy activities with your family. Medical bills are piling up. Don't trust your future to an out-of-town or out-of-state law firm. Door Law Office is a part of our community. Our attorneys are local, fighting for our neighbors in the Lowcountry. Door Law Office. Experience, tradition, integrity, excellence.
Beaufort is the kind of place you never want to leave. So what better place to build, live out dreams, and carve the future? A place for creators to converge and connect. The innovators, the moneymakers, the collaborators, those who imagine a new Beaufort and beyond. A place that intersects diversity, deep historical roots, and modern technological advancements. A place to scale your business and build your brand. We're the Beaufort Digital Corridor, your co-working space, business incubator, and technological hub. Welcome to your place to do more.
I hope you're enjoying the game as much as I am. My name is Javon Livingston, founder of Beaufort Zone, and we're looking for sponsors for our live streams. We're going to be broadcasting Beaufort High sports all year long. So you name it, football, volleyball, basketball, softball, baseball, all right here on Beaufort Zone. And we're looking for sponsors. So send us an email at info@beaufortzone.com.
Beaufort, Ridgeland, Hampton, Walterboro, Hardyville. If you've been injured in an accident, Door Law offices are available 24 hours a day.
An accident can change your life in a moment. You miss work. You can't enjoy activities with your family. Medical bills are piling up. Don't trust your future to an out-of-town or out-of-state law firm. Door Law Office is a part of our community. Our attorneys are local, fighting for our neighbors in the Lowcountry. Door Law Office. Experience, tradition, integrity, excellence.
Beaufort is the kind of place you never want to leave. So what better place to build, live out dreams, and carve the future? A place for creators to converge and connect. The innovators, the moneymakers, the collaborators, those who imagine a new Beaufort and beyond. A place that intersects diversity, deep historical roots, and modern technological advancements. A place to scale your business and build your brand. We're the Beaufort Digital Corridor, your co-working space, business incubator, and technological hub. Welcome to your place to do more.
I hope you're enjoying the game as much as I am. My name is Javon Livingston, founder of Beaufort Zone. And we're looking for sponsors for our live streams. We're going to be broadcasting Beaufort High sports all year long. So you name it, football, volleyball, basketball, softball, baseball, all right here on Beaufort Zone. And we're looking for sponsors. So send us an email at info@beaufortzone.com.
Beaufort, Ridgeland, Hampton, Walterboro, Hardyville. If you've been injured in an accident, Door Law Offices are available 24 hours a day.
An accident can change your life in a moment. You miss work. You can't enjoy activities with your family. Medical bills are piling up. Don't trust your future to an out-of-town or out-of-state law firm. Door Law Office is a part of our community. Our attorneys are local, fighting for our neighbors in the Lowcountry. Door Law Office. Experience, tradition, integrity, excellence.
Beaufort is the kind of place you never want to leave. So what better place to build, live out dreams, and carve the future? A place for creators to converge and connect. The innovators, the moneymakers, the collaborators, those who imagine a new Beaufort and beyond. A place that intersects diversity, deep historical roots, and modern technological advancements. A place to scale your business and build your brand. We're the Beaufort Digital Corridor, your co-working space, business incubator, and technological hub. Welcome to your place to do more.
I hope you're enjoying the game as much as I am. My name is Javon Livingston, founder of Beaufort Zone. And we're looking for sponsors for our live streams. We're going to be broadcasting Beaufort High sports all year long. So you name it, football, volleyball, basketball, softball, baseball, all right here on Beaufort Zone. And we're looking for sponsors. So send us an email at info@beaufortzone.com.
Beaufort, Ridgeland, Hampton, Walterboro, Hardyville. If you've been injured in an accident, Door Law Offices are available 24 hours a day.
An accident can change your life in a moment. You miss work. You can't enjoy activities with your family. Medical bills are piling up. Don't trust your future to an out-of-town or out-of-state law firm. Door Law Office is a part of our community. Our attorneys are local, fighting for our neighbors in the local.
Welcome back, everybody. That one goes by DePass and trying to keep his balance, trying to find some room, trying to get some positive yardage out of this one. And, you know, he's still up on his feet. It's DePass and making something out of nothing there. It looked like at first it was going to be a bad play there and winds up getting something positive. First down and 10 for the Eagles on the 31-yard line.
Like handoff is to Johnson running up the middle.
Coming in number 24.
Ritty Jr. on the tackle. So that's going to be a first down and 10 for Mr. Johnson.
First down.
Hand off again is to Johnson to the outside. He looks, he's trying to turn on the Jets. Johnson trying to turn it into a foot race, and he's going to be caught going out of bounds at about the 16-yard line. Barnes under center, signals to move Johnson in motion, rolling back. Backside to the big guy, Odom, and he's gonna get hit in the ankle. Nowhere to go. And there go the Eagles trying to pull something out that Andy Reid playbook there with the Chiefs, Patrick Mahomes. It looks like something that they would do there. Giving the big guy a catch, an opportunity there. Try to get him a score close down here by the goal line. Second down there, and a handoff to the opposite side. That's going to be Andrews.
Number four, Jake Andrews.
Now they go heavy. Direct snap to Andrews. Andrews not going down, and a touchdown for Andrews. Kick is up and no good for Kosling. 48-6 here for the Eagles. Up to Kosling on this extra point. Four, once again, trying to go to that far side again. As Kitching always tries to do when he gets the ball on the return. This time brought down.
Yeah. I got that hit to get the block. He get that bass on the low. I got that.
first down and 10. Gadsden rolling out. Looked like he was thinking about running with it. Johnson putting the pressure on, and here come the rest of the Eagles. That's going to be Robbie Winburn getting the sack. Second down and 23 now. Gadsden for the completion. Not going to be enough. Broken up there. Coming over to break it up. Mr. Reese Mullen.
And we got a
official now, folks. The clock is now rolling as Beaufort is up by 42 points here halfway through the third quarter. Gadsden a way to evade the pressure, trying to put on the moves on the feet, and he's not going to be able to get away from Denton. And looks like we got flags on the play coming in there as they get ready for the punt. Fourth and 30. Little snap. Rudy Jr. gets it off. And it's going to be hit as he tried to catch that one. It's going to be picked up by North Charleston. Eli Johnson didn't call for the fair catch there, I don't believe. And on and flags on the play. And here comes. And here comes all the athletic trainers onto the field. Let's see what the call is here before we go to the injury timeout. I guess the penalty is going to go against North Charleston, and we're going to take an injury timeout, and we'll be right back. There go the penalty yards there, marking them off there.
Penalty going against the Cougars there. The hit on the player for the Eagles. We're going to have a first down and 10 Eagle offense inside the 35.
Eagles with the ball handoff by Bonds and going around the right side. Xavier Tobias.
Number 43, Xavier on the carry. Number 43, Xavier Tobias on the carry. Pick up an 8 or 9 on the play. He said, I'm a second down and short.
Off is Tobias again. Tobias going around that right side. Pulled down. Got the first down. Kamarion Smith on the tackle. Another one for Tobias, this time quickly in the backfield. Gregory Parks on the tackle. Bonds looking to throw. He gets one to Priester. Priester around the top of your screen, trying to get towards that first down. It looks like it's going to get a nice size gain. Going to bring up 3 yards to go there. But we got a flag on the ground before we get to 3rd and 3 there. Let's see what the call is. And it's going to be an illegal player downfield. Illegal man downfield on the Eagles. So that's going to negate the play by Priester and back the Eagles on up here.
And an illegal man downfield call going against the Eagles. We're going to back it up.
Second down and long now for the Eagles. Handoff is again to Tobias. And he's brought down once again. Kamarion Smith on the tackle. Bonds looking to throw, tosses one towards the end zone and getting his hands on it. Rashard Clement. And that's going to be a 4th down and 13 for the Eagles. Kaiserland makes his way onto the field, and here goes the field goal unit. kick is short from Kaiserlin. It's no good. Score going to remain 48-6. First down to 10 for North Charleston. Gadsden, ball complete on the outside. The man who got the deflection on the fourth down. Excuse me, on the third down.
No run after catch there from the receiver.
By Clement. Second down and 8. Time rolls down here inside the third quarter. When we get back, fourth quarter action with a rolling collapse. Beaufort High with the lead, 48-6 over North Charleston.
Beaufort, Ridgeland, Hampton, Walterboro, Hardyville. If you've been injured in an accident, Door Law offices are available 24 hours a day.
An accident can change your life in a moment. You miss work. You can't enjoy activities with your family. Medical bills are piling up. Don't trust your future to an out-of-town or out-of-state law firm. Door Law Office is a part of our community. Our attorneys are local, fighting for our neighbors in the Lowcountry. Door Law Office. Experience, tradition, integrity, excellence.
Ridgeland, Hampton, Walterboro, Hardyville. If you've been injured in an accident, Door Law offices are available 24 hours a day.
An accident can change your life in a moment. You miss work. You can't enjoy activities with your family. Medical bills are piling up. Don't trust your future to an out-of-town or out-of-state law firm. Door Law.
Welcome back, everybody. 48-6 Beaufort lead. Fourth quarter action on the way. Here come the subs in for the Eagles as that one is thrown into the dirt by Gadsden. Second down and 10. Gadsden looking for some room to throw. Gets one to the outside. And the short completion to Antoine Spillers.
Coming in on the initial contact. Number 61, Trey Jenkins coming in on the cleanup.
There goes the punt for Riddy Jr. And the ball going to bounce all over to the other side. Going to be picked up at the 35-yard line. First down and 10 for the Eagles. hand off. Tobias with the big hole through the middle. First down and 10. Xavier Tobias on the carry. Hand off again to Tobias around that left hand side. Trying to shake off that tackle by Gregory Parks, but he holds on. And carry it 4 yards, bring up second down and 6.
Where the whole student section going? They just say my wife.
Hand off again to Tobias. So they're going to let it get Tobias. This time a short carry. Nowhere to go. Ready Jr. in there on the tackle. And flags on the play. Offsides on the defense. First and 10, hand off to Tobias around the left-hand side, trying to find some room. He gets across the 20-yard line, first down and 10. Bonds looking for some room. He gets another one to Priest. The Priest around the right-hand side. He gets enough for the first down. Will be chased down by Richard Hazel. Richard Hazel. Low snap, picked up, hand off to Tobias. And he's going to be brought down at the line of scrimmage. Big number 78, Jaden Capers. And we got a flag on the play. And that's going to be holding against the Eagles. Going to drop back a couple of steps. And it's going to be second down and goal, but the ball is going to be on that 16-yard line. The handoff is going to be to Tobias again around the left-hand side. And it looks like he's going to get about 8 yards on the play. Make a third down and 8. Going to keep it himself, running through the middle, touchdown, Samari Bonds. We'll be right back. Man, the kick is blocked, looks like. And no kick good.
No good on the play. 6 minutes to go here in the Eagle Nest. Score 54. Cougars 6.
And as time winds down here in the fourth quarter, don't forget, you can check out the Loco Pigskin Live podcast on Facebook tonight at 11:30 p.m. Beaufort High, your own Jimmy Sosa will be sure to tune in tonight with Justin Jarrett, Wes Kirk, and crew live as they wrap up all the scores from the Loco, including Colleton and Ridgeland. Don't forget to check those guys out. They wrap up all the scores and let you know what's going on and get ready for playoff scenarios as well here as we get in the final weeks of the regular season here. So once again, that's the Loco Pigskin Live podcast tonight on Fridays at 11:30. Kick fielded at the 15-yard line. That's Jaden Sparks making off the big hit attempt, but around the right-hand side. It's going to be a 20-yard return. Good, Jaden Sparks. Gadsden empties up the backfield. Trying to find Thurman. He will take off and run. He will here. Trying to go around that right-hand side. Being chased down. Having to stretch it out. But it looks like he... Second down and two. Burn quickly throws it to the outside, gets it to his guy, Rashard Clement, breaking some tackles. They're refusing to go down. He's going to get the first down and more as he gets into Eagle territory. Ball going to be spotted on the 46-yard line. First down and 10. Gadsden looking to throw. In that backfield, trying to find some room, and he's going to be brought down to 61, Trey Jenkins. Time over every boy and every girl. High snap there to Gadsden. Gadsden throws one over the middle. Ball complete. Nice move towards the outside by John Brown, and he's racing inside the red zone. Ball now deep inside Eagles territory. Looking to score one here before the end of the game. Gadsden, quick throw to the outside. He's got John Brown again. Looking, surveying, throws one to the back of the end zone. It's going to be caught. Touchdown, North Charleston, Antonio Spiller. Man, 52-12, just over a minute left to go in the game. Gadsden rolling, trying to find someone, and almost dropped. And they're going to say it was dropped. Not able to hold on to it was John Brown. Score going to remain 54-12. 1 minute left to go. Again, I want to thank everybody for tuning in here tonight. I want to thank everybody for tuning in. Again, if you enjoy our coverage of local high school sports, you can always text Beaufort to 801-801. And the next step in our process is we want to get cellular bonding to help us to be able to get a great signal no matter where we go. As you see, we went to Aner earlier this week, well, actually yesterday, and it was just tough conditions out there, especially when you go inside gyms and against the basketball and wrestling season here on Beaufort's own here in a couple weeks. So definitely appreciate your support. All donations count, big or small. That is Beaufort to 801-801. Rudy Jr. on the kick, filled it at about the 30-yard line, trying to find the lane is Patterson on the kick return, and a little bit of shoving there, Camarion Smith there, a little bit of upset. Probably a little bit of trash talk there at the end of the game. And usually bound to get one shove in a blowout like this, somebody from the losing team is going to be upset, something's going to get said. But the score is 54-12, so it's not much you can do. I'm going to tell you what, though, Kavarian Smith, I think he leads the team, if I'm not mistaken, when I was looking at the stats, with 12 tackles a game, and you've seen it here tonight, and it's got to be frustrating when you're a player like that, and you can, you know, muster, I mean, let alone get 10 or, you know, 8 tackles in high school, but 12 tackles a game is a very impressive stat for Kavarian Smith. You know, more to him to the game, and, you know, even if he's the only person that can, you know, make the tackles necessarily, and still, to be able to chase it down, and you watch film every week, these teams, and I'm pretty sure live on the season, and Matter made a game plan to make sure you stop Camaria from getting from the ball, you never know, but To still be able to pull that off, 12 tackles a game. Camarion Smith, just a good piece for that North Charleston team. A little bit of frustration right there. And it looks like they're in victory formation. Samari Bonds, and he's going to take a knee right here. And that's going to do it for the night, folks. As time runs out, Beaufort is going to win 54-12. And they're going to travel to North Charleston next week. An opportunity to battle out Hanahan. And final update, forgot to check on that Hanahan score. And it hasn't been updated here on our end since the half. It's still 28-13 is what we got here. But an opportunity there for them to battle for first place in the region next week. Don't go anywhere. Stay tuned. I want to thank everybody for tuning in here tonight on the Beaufort Zone. My name is Javon Livingston. Once again, have a great night.